Huwag maging backseat driver and be up to date. Be up to date. Latest car news, motoring stories, at industry analysis. Gearbox. Ang roadmap mo sa mga pinakabago sa mundo ng automotive. Start the engine. Buckle up and steer the wheel. Car enthusiast man o baguhan, siguradong madaming matututunan. Gearbox. Gearbox na. Hosted by Eric Tipan at Nana Nadal. Dito sa Radyo Pilipinas, 738 AM.
Magandang hapon sa inyo lahat and welcome to GearBox dito sa Radyo Pilipinas, 738 AM. Live na live po tayo on the radio. We may have started a little late para po, syempre, ma-accommodate natin yung speech ni Presidente. But we're here nevertheless. Eric Tipan kasama si Nana Nadal. And you can also catch the show online.
Yes, good afternoon. We are also on Facebook. Please look for @GearboxRP1 para mapanood nyo kami. Kung kayo nasa Instagram, paki-follow ang @GearBox on air at nasa YouTube din kami under the same name @GearBox on air.
All right. Ito pong show medyo delayed start tayo but we'll try to make up for it. Subukan na natin ipasok yung guest natin, first guest of the day. We will try to get in touch with him para ma-contact na po siya. We have two guests of course. We'll be talking later on about food. Ang dami nating food topics pa lang ngayon, no? I mean, Migs will be here on the show, Migs Torres Experience, and then we're gonna talk about another, ito more event than just plain food, you know, than just a plain dish.
It's destination.
It's a destination, that's right. So, abangan po natin yan. A little later on, a little past 6 p.m., we're gonna talk about that, food destination, okay?
Yeah.
But samantala,
actually, our destinations first guest, yan eh.
Marami, oo. Oh. Our first guest of the day, we welcome mula po sa Blade Auto Center. Our first guest, we're going to be speaking to Robert Tan. Robert, magandang hapon. Welcome to GearBox.
Hello. Good afternoon sa lahat ng audience ng GearBox. Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat.
Now, Robert, para sa mga hindi pa nakakaalam, and I know there are very few because your place, I guess, is a one-stop auto shop. Ika nga, ano? But for those who don't know what is Blade Auto Center at kailan ito nagsimula?
Oh, tayo ay nagsimula sa ano nung taong 2004. Tayo ay isang car accessory center at ang pakay ng ating tindahan ay manilbi sa mga taong naghahanap ng magagandang car accessories sa napaka-convenient na paraan. Tayo ay nagsimula sa isang shopping mall sa Market sa Fort Bonifacio at magmula nung nagbukas tayo ng unang store, nagpasukan na lahat ng mga offer sa atin at sa isang maiksing panahon nakapagbukas tayo ng isang malaking network ng stores sa buong Pilipinas.
When you started, what were the products that you were carrying? Sabi mo nagpasukan lahat, so I guess hindi pa ganito kadami nung nagsimula kayo.
Oh, nagsimula kasi tayo sa wala eh kasi parang ano, we literally started from zero, bagong-bago yung konsepto. Nais nating gawing ano eh, nais nating dalhin yung traditional na pinupuntahan natin noong time na binata pa tayo, pumupunta tayo ng Manawe, pumupunta tayo saan para magpakabit ng car accessories. Pero yung mga lugar na yun kasi hindi masyadong convenient and hindi nagiging maganda yung experience ng ating mga users. Tapos pinagsama namin yung konsepto na yun at pinasok natin sa isang parang boutique na environment. Nagsimula tayo, nagbebenta tayo ng motor oil, steering wheel covers, mga ganyan. Pero nagbebenta rin tayo ng mga damit, na mga car-branded na damit.
Oh.
At that time kasi parang gusto natin i-marry yung concept na hardware, automotive, and fashion. Kaya yung tindahan natin, dinesign natin na medyo maliwanag, magaganda yung mga shelves, magaganda yung merchandising. Inayos natin para maging fashionable, yet functional yung mga binebenta nating items. At kaya tayo tinangkilik ng maraming tao dahil masarap naman pumunta ng shopping mall, mabilis mag-park, tapos walang problema ang parking, hindi nyo ikakatatakutan ang security ng shopping mall, di ba? At the same time, na-develop natin yung isang imahe na pwedeng iabot sa atin yung susi at walang mawawala sa kanilang sasakyan. Ikakabit natin ng maayos yung iyong radio, yung TV, tapos habang kayo ay nagsha-shopping, habang kayo ay nagsusupermarket o nanood kayo ng sine, pagbalik ninyo, tapos na yung trabaho at mauuwi nyo na yung car ninyo na kasama yung upgraded na entertainment system at kung ano man yung nais mo ipakabit sa iyong sasakyan.
Wow, hindi ko alam yun ah! Meron palang gano'n!
Hindi kasi lumalabas masyado, Nana eh.
Oo. Ano na, Nana, ano na tayo? 15 taon na nating ginagawa ito.
Wow.
At marami na tayong napatuwang customer kasi finally, nadala na sa shopping mall environment yung ganitong konsepto. Mm-hmm. Wherein dati kailangan kang pumunta doon sa mga tabi-tabi na tindahan. Ngayon, meron ng isang reputable na chain. Ito na yung Blade Box Center.
Oh. I'm familiar with Blade, but hindi ko alam na pati yung installation ng mga binibili, pwede. Yung parang nagulat ako dun sa partner. And I think, ha, yung kinukwento mo na yung made it a boutique environment, nasa mall, aircon. Alam mo, I think in particular, mga babae ang mag-benefit dyan. Kasi, di ba, hindi naman namin type pumunta dun sa mga banapo, eh. Sabi mo, magsuyod-suyod sa iba-ibang shops dun. So, pinadali mo actually to para sa mga katulad ko.
Totoo yun, Nana. Yun talaga yung purpose ng ating company. To make it very convenient para sa mga hindi sanay pumunta sa mga high street market para ayusin yung kanilang sasakyan. Alam mo, Nana and Eric, ang sasakyan kasi parang cellphone natin yan eh. Nais nating i-personalize, nais nating ilagay yung touch natin. Meron tayong gustong mas magandang sound system, gusto nating mas maganda yung mas naaamoy natin yung flavor na gusto natin maamoy, di ba? Ang sasakyan is next to our home. Dahil sa traffic, ito na yung parang second home natin eh. We spend at least 2 hours, 3 hours per day in our cars. Kaya dapat lang na gawin nating maganda yung environment, masarap yung feeling, motivating pa rin, inspiring pa rin, para pagdating natin sa destination natin, ganadong-ganado pa rin tayo at gawin yung dapat nating gawin.
That's a nice parang overall concept of what the store should provide yung consumers. Ano? Kasi before, back in the day, if you really wanted an accessory, maghahanap ka sa iba't ibang store eh. Kulalo na kung magka-canvas ka, you have to move around. And Blade Auto Center really made it easy. Ako, dyan ako nagpakabit nung wiring para dun sa dashcam, tint. Marami nang nakukuha sa Blade Auto Center eh. So, and again, like what Robert was saying, it's not anymore, hindi ka na kailangan lumayo, pumunta sa, out of your way para makakuha ng mga accessories or maipakabit ito. You can go to the mall. Nung pwede pang mag-mall, nung wala pang pandemic, punta ka, mamasyal ka, iwanan mo yung car mo, and by the time you're done, pagkatapos mo mag-lunch with your family or manood ng sine or shop for clothes, pagbalik mo, nakakabit na, you didn't have to technically parang waste time sitting somewhere waiting for it to get done.
Yes, Eric. And to add to that, you have peace of mind kasi lahat tayo, ang tao natin, lahat naka-uniforme. Pag inabot mo yung susi sa isang naka-blade na uniform, alam mo na secure yung iyong mga gamit. Yung sunglasses mo, hindi mawawala. Yung wiper mo, pagbalik mo, nandyan pa. Yun. We pride ourselves by building a good name and a good reputation. Meron kayong pupuntahan kapag may problem, may concerns, meron kayong babalikan at kami, we honor our commitments to all our customers. And probably that is why mahal na mahal kami ng mga customers natin.
Kaya naman, tinatangkilik talaga kayo. Now, you mentioned 15 years already in the business, Robert. What challenges did you face nung nagsisimula kayo?
When we started, lahat kaming mga incorporators ng company, walang experience sa retail, walang experience sa pagbubukas ng tindahan, walang experience at all sa ganyang bagay. Lahat to purely based on desire to make it successful, pinaghirapan, pinagpawisan. Dugot-pawis ang pumasok dito and we had to learn everything from scratch to make sure that the store operates perfectly. Parang nag-develop tayo ng isang parang cookie cutter na formula. Parang once na perfect mo tong isa, tuloy-tuloy na lang, duplicate ka na lang ng duplicate at yun yung naging importante. From the very beginning, we operated our first store as if parang franchised concept. No? Yun yung ginamit naming idea. We looked at Jollibee, we looked at McDonald's. Paano nila natuturuan yung tao magluto ng perfect hamburger and perfect french fries? Diba? So, alam din namin na nagsisimula, wala tayong puhunan, at maliit ang ating puhunan, at hindi natin ma-afford mag-hire ng mga magagaling na graduate from big schools and stuff like that. So, sinimulan namin the same concept as Jollibee. Nag-build tayo ng system, at itong system na to, pinatupad na lang natin paulit-ulit. Kaya, mabilis na gawa natin, i-duplicate yung store number 1, na-duplicate natin sa store number 2, na-duplicate natin sa store number 3. At ito, importante to Eric and Nana, kasi pag pumunta ka sa isang blade, alam mo, pag pinuntahan mo yung pangalawa, pangatlong blade, pareho ang experience na mararanasan mo. Including yung music na maririnig mo, yung atmosphere, yung colors, all of them makikita mo pare-pareho na in all the stores.
Very consistent, ano? At since minensyon mo na rin na paulit-ulit, di ba? Ilang ulit na ba? Ilang stores na ba meron ng blade?
As of now, we have more than 50 stores nationwide.
Oh, wow.
Umabot na tayo ng Cebu, Davao, Zamboanga, General Santos, Bacolod, Iloilo, and sa Manila naman, sa Luzon, umabot na tayo ng Cabanatuan, Nueva Ecija, Lucena, Batangas, yun. And coming very very soon, magkakaroon na rin tayo ng isang store sa SM Baguio.
Wow.
50 stores.
So, madaming ulit na pala yun na sinasabi na yun. Uulit din ang experience ng blade sa isa, pangalawa, pangatlo, pang 50 na ba?
50 na.
So, hinahanap sa atin.
Years.
Hinahanap sa atin. Kasi tayo, nagbebenta tayo ng very good quality product and very, very affordable. Pero hindi malaki kasi margin natin. Kaya kung hindi namin kinalat to at dumami yung tindahan, hindi natin ma-afford na mapanatiling mababa ang ating presyo. Hindi natin mapapanatiling affordable yung ating produkto kung hindi natin nilakihan yung ating network. No, basically, ang nangyari dito is pagkausap natin yung supplier, parang pag bumili kami ng isang dosena, that's isang dosena times 50. Kaya yung mga suppliers, walang choice kundi ibigay sa atin yung lesser than wholesale prices.
Nice.
And in return, pinapasa naman natin sa customers yung discounted price na nakukuha natin. Mm-hmm. Kaya ang prices natin, parate magugulat kayo, kung i-compare nyo sa mga tindahan sa tabi-tabi, hindi tayo lumalayo ng presyo. And yet, nasa shopping mall.
Hindi tabi-tabi yung experience. Hindi tabi-tabi yung experience.
Yes.
Where is store number 1, Robert? Alin ang store number 1?
Store number 1 is Market in Fort Bonifacio. Nung time na yun, yung nagsimula tayo, talahib pa yun, yung buong Fort Bonifacio. Wala pa yung mga building, wala pa dun yung mga magagandang nakikita natin ngayon. Pero we took a leap of faith, no? Kasi I was employed for 20 years and then we decided time na para magsimula ng sariling negosyo para we can have something of our own. Mm-hmm. I was 37 years old then. And then, sabi namin ni Mrs. ko, tsaka nung aking sister-in-law, sige, subukan nga natin. Let's take a crack at this. And then, we started our own first store. Kami-kami yung nagbabantay. Kami yung nagwawalis. Kami yung kasabay na. Kami kumakain ng barbecue doon sa baba, si Aling Ining. Yun. Kami-kami yung nag-operate ng store when we started.
Ilig.
And then, dumating lang sa point na hindi na namin kaya bantayan mag-isa. Kaya nag-hire tayo ng nag-hire ng tao at natulungan tayo na palakihin at palaguin yung ating kumpanya. So.
Galing. So aside from cars, nagki-cater din ba kayo sa mga motorsiklo? Ano ba?
Ah, yes, Nana. Kasi recent 2-3 years ago, we started venturing into other mobility products kasi
okay.
Somehow, na-establish na natin yung car accessory or car-related products. At ang tao parang is still hungry for more. Kasi ang customers natin na may sasakyan, meron din silang motorsiklo. Meron din silang bisikleta. Meron din silang scooter. Kaya unti-unti nagdagdag na tayo ng mga items sa ating mga stores. We now carry motorcycle accessories. We also sell motorcycles. We are a dealer of Vespa. sa ating store.
Oh, okay.
We carry scooters. Alam nyo, recently, very very popular ang kick scooter na yon, di ba? We carry Segway, we carry 9-bot scooters. Tapos, we also carry bicycles now. We sell mountain bikes and children's bikes as well.
And syempre, pati rin mga parts and accessories ng mga lahat na yan, ano?
Yes, yes.
So, total.
May helmet din tayo pala, Eric. May helmet tayo.
So, total mga mobility solutions, ha?
Oo, yun na. Parang, ano, kinuha na natin yung mobility family rather than limiting ourselves to cars.
That's smart. That's the great way to look at it. Ano na, yun nga, hindi lang kotse ang ginagamit ng tao. Tama ka, kick scooter, dami na may ganyan ngayon because of you don't want to take public transportation because of COVID-19. So, pwedeng scooter, lalo na yung iba, electric scooter yung ginagamit nila. So, it's easier for you. Hindi mo kailangan sumipa ng sumipa, pumidal ng pumidal. Now, you mentioned kanina, Robert, installation ano, of devices. Anong mga device ang pwedeng i-install sa inyo? And can they only install yung what was bought sa inyo? Or do you offer installation services as well?
We actually install items from outside. Pero as much as possible, we avoid doing that. Kasi the installation service itself, I can guarantee na maayos to. Pero yung item na kinakabit, pag hindi namin kilala yung source, hindi natin alam kung defective ba o merong internal problems or issues, hindi namin magarantiya ito.
Mm-hmm.
Pero anything na binili natin sa store natin, we install for free. May minimum ano lang tayo, may minimum order lang. Pag above 3,000 pesos, we do the installation for you. So typically, if you buy a radio system, you buy a TV system, or even car alarms, we install it already for you.
Eh pag hindi, yung pag smaller items, tas hindi free, mga magkano yung range ng installation fee?
Typically, nasa ano yun, mga 500 pesos and above.
Okay.
It's basically just to cover the cost of the time of the installer.
Yes. Yeah.
Pero ano lang, at least sure ka na blade-trained person ang gumagawa nito. Yun.
Oh, tsaka siya na magbubukas ng item, di ba? So, doon na mismo. So, how did the pandemic change your operations? Kasi nga, mall-based kayo, di ba madaming malls ang hindi bukas or madaming bawal. Paano nagbago ang inyong sistema?
First of all, Nana, as of now, lahat ng stores natin bukas na.
Okay.
Kasi ang household hardware and automotive are essentials, no? Essential services.
Oo.
Kaya ang tao ano nung time na nakakulong tayo sa bahay, alam mo iniisip mo, teka may tulo yung bubong ko, kailangan ko ayusin, di ba? Tapos yung trip natira, di ba? And a large portion of our customers na iwan sa bahay, nami-miss nila yung paglinis ng kanyang sasakyan and lalo pang naging may attention to the details within the car. Kaya nag-orderan sila sa atin ng mga items. Some went to our stores to pick up items, pero a lot of our customers went to blade.ph. Ito yung ating online store, 24 hours a day operational, at doon sila nagpe-place ng kanilang orders. At ang Blade din ay available sa Lazada and Shopee, kaya maraming avenues wherein they can place their orders. Yun. Tapos dinideliver natin to sa bahay nila.
Yung Blade.ph ba, sinimulan nyo lang because of the pandemic or dati pa kayong merong online setup?
Tagal na, mga siguro 3 years before the pandemic o 4 years before the pandemic.
Okay.
Nandun na yung ating store.
Ready, ready.
Lazada and Shopee, matagal na rin bukas yun.
And yung amount of
medyo na-highlight lang yung tindahan. Medyo na-highlight yung tindahan during the pandemic. Lalong napansin ng tao. Kasi namimiss nila ang Blade. Wala sila mapuntahan. Tapos nakita nila meron na pala online.
Online.
Kaya biglang dumami yung ating customers online during the pandemic.
But the amount of products na available, Robert, sa store, all of that also available online. So you can really order whatever's on this in the store, physical store, it's also available online.
Almost all are available online. Ang hindi lang namin mailagay online ay yung mga mabibigat o malaki na hindi kaya sa Ninja Van at yung hindi kaya nila la-move. Yun. Pero ano, we even mountain bikes we sell online.
Pwede.
Mountain bikes, yeah. We
so ano lang ang hindi kaya? Generator, mga
ganun? Yung Vespa. Yung Vespa.
So pag Vespa, binili mo, pick up na lang.
Pinipick up nila sa ating store sa Mindanao Avenue. We have a new superstore in Mindanao Avenue. Ito, merong Vespa showroom sa baba, meron tayong super car accessory store sa second floor, at yung likod nito is an upcoming service center. We will eventually do oil change, tune up, and all the other motoring services. Eventually, yun yung gagawin doon sa tindahan.
Sa Mindanao. Mga kailan tong eventually na to? Kailan, anong timetable natin dyan?
We're looking at having them all operational within the year. So right now, yung Vespa showroom is open na and the superstore is open na. Ang yung oil change tune up lang ang hindi pa open sa Mindanao Avenue.
And
this is going to be the first Blade Superstore. Is that what it's going to be called also? Blade Superstore?
That will be the first Blade Superstore, yes, Eric.
Wow.
Ito yung first na complete service. We attempted to do that in Timog Avenue, pero because of lack of experience nga, nagkulang ng foresight in terms of space and the frontage and all of that, nagkaroon kami ng konting pagkukulang sa foresight. Kaya whatever yung na-miss namin, na-correct na natin sa Mindanao Avenue.
Now.
So you needed a bigger space, huh?
We need a bigger space, and also the way everything is laid out, kailangan nakakonsider na yung motor shop sa likod before you plan your building. Hindi namin naisip right. Na ganun kailangan.
Mm-hmm. May nakita akong interesting sa website. You sell Blade gift certificates. Meron pa rin ba ito ngayon?
Meron. Kasi yung
this
iba...
This means a very practical gift.
Oo, kasi some do not know what to give to their girlfriends. Yeah. Some girlfriends do not know what to give to their boyfriends.
Yes.
Pero alam nila na gusto niya ng car accessory. Kaya we prepared gift checks as well para bahala na si boyfriend bumili o bahala na si tatay bumili. Yun.
Tama yun. Now, going back online, one quick question about it. What are the payment options sa delivery options if you buy online?
For Lazada and Shopee, they accept credit card. Many options sa Lazada and Shopee. Sa Blade.ph, meron tayong karagdagang isang option, which is COD. Yun. We accept COD sa Blade.ph as well as credit card. Kung ano man ibang mga payment meron. Paymaya, mga ganun. And GCash too pala.
Pati GCash. And then delivery, yung buyer ang mag-book or do you guys take care of that?
We take care of everything, including yung delivery sa bahay. All they have to do is to settle a small fee, which is included already in the purchase.
Okay. And then, kanina, I went to your Facebook page at meron akong naabutan, no?
Uh-oh.
Na ang tawag ata ay Blade Radio Live.
Ah, yes.
Meron nga akong nakita. Familiar. Yung host na nakita ko kanina.
Ano po?
Ano ba yun?
Well, we've been teasing and testing the entertainment industry kasi alam nyo, Nana and Eric, personal na hilig ko kasi yung entertainment industry. Pero I feel na mahihirapan ako na patakbuhin yung isang ganyang klaseng negosyo dahil maraming mga challenges. At the same time, yung mga big companies are already in that field. So for us to be successful, medyo may kahirapan ito at recognize ko naman yung aking limitation. So what we did was, ang marketing department ng Blade, nag-focus on producing entertainment items or products. No? Like, we so far have made 5 movies already. And itong 5 movies na ito ay nag-garner na ng more than 10 million views sa YouTube. In fact, recently, nakatanggap kami ng isang Silver Play Button Award for our YouTube channel because ang daming clamor sa ating mga pelikula. At ang ating mga movies ay, nakakatawa nga eh, ang ating mga movies ay available sa Green Hills and Quiapo. You can buy our DVD na pirated. You can also download it in Green Hills. Kami lang yung napirata, natutuwa kasi itong mga pelikula natin, lahat ay ano eh, itong mga pelikula natin, lahat ay in a way matantad ng mga product placements and promotion 'yon. So,
paano ko mapapanood 'yan kung hindi ako mag hindi ako bibili ng pirated DVD? Saan siya napapanood?
Ano, libre siya. Libre siya, Nana. Just go to Blade Auto Center in YouTube, watch our movie, okay. And it's free. And then mag-post, mag-subscribe okay. lang kayo para ano, yun lang yung hinihingi namin. Mag-subscribe ka at mag-comment-comment ka din sa mga movie, yun lang hinihingi namin. Libre yung mga movies natin para panoorin. Yung unang ni-launch natin sa YouTube, which is 12 Days to Destiny, simula pa lang, nagkaroon na siya ng almost 3 million views na kaagad eh. At tapos hiningi na sa amin yung sequel. Kaya naglabas na tayo ng The Next 12 Days Part 1, The Next 12 Days Part 2, at ngayon hinahanap na sa atin yung Part 3, which is niluluto na natin ngayon. Ang title ng movie is The Last 12 Days. Naging, ano na, naging trilogy na siya.
Galing!
Oh,
so is this
i-launch
romance?
Pandemic, ha? I-launch natin ito.
Usap na nga lang kayo, hanapin ko na ngayon.
Is this, anong theme ng film? Is this romance? Is this comedy?
This is ano, this is a rom-com movie starring Akihiro Blanco and Mary Joy Apostol. Tapos, sumunod dito, nagkaroon din tayo ng isang theatrical release naman ng another movie called Dito Lang Ako. This one stars John Lucas, GMA to, John Lucas, si Michelle Vito, tsaka Boots Anson Roa and Freddie Webb. May cameo appearance pa si, ano, si James Deakin dito. Tapos sa ano, sa The Next
World. Mga kailan to? Itong Dito Lang Ako.
That one we launched in 2018. Tapos,
12 Days to Destiny
was ano, 2019 naman yung 12 Days to Destiny. The Next 12 Days is 2020. And then 2021, wala pa kami na-release. Pero, noong 2020, nag-release tayo ng dalawang full-length movie, including Good Times Bad. And, one of those movies pala, nandun si Colonel Bong Nebrijas. Ano, bilang, ano, cameo
appearance.
Oh. Yun. So, during this pandemic time, nakita natin na parang maganda na may ganyang entertainment. We were the first to release a digital movie during pandemic time. Tapos, towards November, nag-release tayo ng second digital movie, all for free sa ating mga customers. And then, sobrang na-enjoy natin, sabi ng marketing department, gawa nga tayo ng ano, live selling, kunyari may DJ, may host, ganyan-ganyan. And somehow, may na-trigger silang itch sa aking katawan. Nagulat sila, sabi ko, sige, set up na lang natin, gawin na nating daily show, araw-arawin na natin. Kaya doon na nanganak, doon na lumabas yung Blade Radio. Kasi ever since meron naman tayong recorder na radio show eh. Yung naririnig niyo sa store, yeah. Lahat 'yun puro original music 'yun, walang hindi to kinopya from somewhere else. All the songs.
Saka hindi siya piped in radio. Hindi siya
piped.
Kinuha lang sa echo.
Recorded. It's all recorded and all the songs that we have there ay written and performed by top bands of the Philippines nung panahon ko. No, so nandun si True Fate, si The Dawn, si Neo Colors, lahat to puro original song made for Blade.
Wow. Galing.
Nana, nag-launch rin pala kami ng CD sa ano, sa Spotify.
If you go to Spotify, car accessory store pala yung pinapag-usapan natin. okay, again, sa Spotify,
you can ano, just look for either Dito Lang Ako, ito yung original movie soundtrack natin, at nandun din yung Blade, Bandang Blade Motoring Music Festival. So all the songs that you hear in our stores, nilabas natin dun sa CD. Para, kasi yung iba parang gusto kopyahin, gusto humingi ng USB. So nilabas na lang natin sa Spotify para maging available siya worldwide.
Galing.
Tapos, from there, sabi ko, kung gagawa ka ng radio show, dapat original yung mga music mo. Kaya ginawa namin yung Blade Radio on the stores, ginawa lang namin FB Live and YouTube Live. Tapos nag-invite tayo ng mga magagaling sa kanya-kanyang industriya. Every day, ginawa nating ibang show. Like Mondays, nandun si Senpai Kasu, medyo ano to, Kalokohan, Pilyo Sim. Sa Tuesdays, nandun si Love Joseco, ito naman, motorcycle themed yung ating store. Ang ating story. Tapos sa Wednesday, nandun si I think si Mr. Wright, ano to, mga love story, letter reading, mga ganon. No? Tapos sa third page, nandun yung daily drive. Yung isang kaibigan natin, nandoon ngayon, siya ang ating rotated host. Ang daily drive is our car-related na show. Kaya nag-hire tayo ng mga experts na papasok doon, katulad ni Eric Tipan.
Maraming salamat for the opportunity. It's so much fun, by the way. You know, get all that information mula sa mga auto brands, mga auto accessories, and then tell it to the listeners. Ano? So catch it every Thursday, 11 in the morning, and then 2 p.m. If you can't catch it live, pwede niyo siya mapanood sa YouTube, Blade Auto Center, or on Facebook. You can always replay it.
Yes, yes. Yun.
So Thursday si Eric.
Thursday si Eric, yung daily drive. Tapos Fridays, ito yung ating Bloody Boom. Ito yung parang game show type. Doon namimigay tayo ng mga premyo, namimigay ng kung ano-ano. Yun. Tapos sa Saturdays, ano nga ba yung Saturday natin? Saturday is What's Up Blader. Ito yung parang rotating host din to. Doon pumapasok yung sila Eva Ronda, sila Joko Loco, yung mga galing ng MOR, galing ng iba-ibang stations. Doon sila umupo sa ating station para magkaroon ng tuloy-tuloy na variety ng ating program. Tinawag natin tong Blade Radio Live, pero it's actually a Facebook Live and YouTube Live show. Ang kung titingnan niyo, medyo binantayan namin yung cinematography ng ating ano, kaya medyo maayos yung itsura ng ating ano.
Maganda yung booth. And it's
kasi ano, may gamit pa. Sabi ko kay Eric kanina, ang ganda ng headset.
Magandang microphone. It simulates a radio station. And it actually, malaki lang siya na booth. It's like a radio station booth but bigger. As yung setup with the lights. Kasi nga, kailangan ng ilaw because this is may camera, on-screen component. But when it comes to yung radio part of it, it's complete. Maganda yung, wala nga lang siyang console because we don't play a lot of music. It's more of a talk show. Mm-hmm. But aside from that, got a great mic, great desk, and a big booth. So if you want to find out kung ano nangyayari sa loob ng radio station, it's kind of like that. Watch Blade Radio Live.
Especially on Thursdays, 11 a.m.
Saka namimigay din kami pag Thursday, ah. Si Robert, di sinama eh. Namimigay din kami pag Thursday. Mas konti nga lang yung price ko pag Thursday. Pero namimigay din kami. Sumunod kayo because there's twice you have a chance to win. One at 11, one at 2 o'clock. Mas konti nga lang kesa sa Bloody Boom, but meron din kami yung price.
Yes, yes. Alam mo, Eric, ano to eh. Yung room where we have Blade Radio Live now used to be our training room. We used to invite all our coordinators, our leaders. Doon kami gumagawa ng product training, tsaka orientation. When we hire new people, yun yung kwarto na ginagamitan for those kinds of training. Pero alam natin, due to pandemic, at least mga dalawang taon, hindi magagamit yung kwarto. Kaya doon na nanggaling yung idea na, sige, let's make it productive. Unti-unti, sinet up lang isang table, isang ilaw. Eh, yung ilaw na available, na ginagamit ninyo sa studio, ano na yun eh, dati na naming ilaw yun kasi once a month meron kaming little gathering or mini party in the company. We celebrate mass and then after that we have dinner with everybody para to keep everyone motivated and happy. Pero alam na rin natin due to pandemic, at least dalawang taon hindi magagamit yung kwarto. Yeah. So magiging unproductive yung item na yun. Kaya ginamit na lang natin. Tapos naging isang perfect studio pa siya.
Ganda, actually ganda. If you see it sa nanood kayo sa YouTube nga or sa Facebook, it really looks, the setup is really nice.
Yeah. Yeah. Actually, tinatanong mo si Eric kanina eh, na parang, oh, ano ba, nanang studio ba siya? Anong setup? Kasi parang ang ganda. Ang ganda ng quality ng sound, ang ganda nga ng mga itsura nito, ano, ng lighting. I am so amazed and impressed how you've stretched yung idea na car accessories, tapos yung marketing nyo, naging movie, naging CD, naging radio.
Yeah, may music, no?
Very innovative. Yeah. Very disruptive, I think.
Nana and Eric, you know, ang automotive industry, napakaliit eh. At kung mag-focus lang kami sa automotive industry, hindi tayo makikilala. And I do believe that by going to Love Story, by going to radio, by going to do, by doing everything that we have done, at least lumalawak ang ating sakop, lumalawak ang ating brand awareness, at yun naman yung purpose nito. No, whether may kotse ka o wala, at least kilala mo ang Blade. And then by the time na kailangan mo na, meron ka ng top of mind brand na nasa isip. No. Yun yung idea behind this. Yeah.
Great, great work. Ano? I've been with Robert and Blade Auto Center for what, 2 weeks? Mm-hmm. And dami ko pa natutunan ngayon. I didn't know about the music. I didn't know about the movies, you know. And it's so refreshing to see na Blade is so much more. Kasi palagi ko inuulit-ulit sa show, Blade Auto Center, Blade Auto Center. But now I realize, and the listeners and the viewers get to realize that Blade is so much more than just, tulad nga sabi ni Robert, auto accessories. And you'll learn more about the brand, the name, you know, the more in the as the time moves along, because you see so many output eh. Yun nga, may music, may Facebook, may movies, and all that. Galing.
Ang galing how you connect with your customers. Not even just customers, sabi mo, even potential customers. Hindi niyo pa customer, kinakaibigan niyo na.
Oh, para everybody who is hardworking, everybody who works at a call center, eventually at a certain point bibili ka rin talaga ng kotse. So why not itanim mo na ngayon para paglaki mo, ready na rin, ready ka na rin.
And you're familiar with the brand already. Now, do you have any promos ngayon, Robert, ongoing sa physical stores and online?
We're doing weekly live selling now. Sa live selling, abangan ninyo kasi lahat ito deeply discounted yung ating premyo. Yung mga items na deeply discounted. And then every week refresh to ng refresh, bago ng bago yung item. Kaya pag may ganyang cases, manood lang kayo parati ng Blade Radio Live. Lalabas i-feature natin yung mga items. And a lot of them are at least 20% to 30% discount. Yung iba 50% pa yung discount. Gagawin nyo lang, imamine lang ninyo. Mine, and then add to cart. Then, makikipag-coordinate kami sa inyo para makuha nyo yung item. At the same time, may libre pa minsan mga promo items na kadikit nung binibili nating items.
Yeah. Yes, Eric. Go ahead.
Ang ating stores, ang ating mga physical stores naman, may regular promo ito. Pero ever since, ang pinapatupad natin dyan is everyday low price. Kaya whether may sale man o wala, para ka na rin nakasale pag pumunta ka sa Blade. Kasi parating very affordable yung ating presyo, very reasonable tayo mag-price ng items.
I just can't wait to make these announcements on the show o sa our daily drive. Pagka sabi mo nga, when manood sila, because they'll find out about these promos. Can't wait to make these announcements because maraming nanonood and they're all very eager to know anong bago, saan sila makakamura, saan sila makakatipid. So, looking forward to that. Social media accounts, Robert, if they wanna find you, alam ko binanggit na natin, but invite them and also, again, tell them kung ano yung hahanapin ng mga keywords.
Ah, yes. Just always remember, Blade Auto Center. That's Blade Auto Center in all our social media. YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Friendster, MySpace, lahat yan, puro Blade Auto Center lang keyword natin. No?
So, and also Lazada and Shopee.
Even in Lazada and Shopee, hanapin nyo lang ang Blade Auto Center. It will lead you to our page. Yes.
Well, thank you very much for your time, Robert. We really do appreciate it. Very eye-opening to find out what Blade is all about. Yeah. No? Everything that you guys are busy with and looking forward to that next movie. I can't wait to see you. Si Nana.
Mamayang gabi.
No. Hindi
na ako nakikinig sa inyo eh. Nasa YouTube na ako.
Oh. Rom-com fan si Nana. Yung mga movies natin. Maintindihan ninyo kung bakit natin ginawa to. Pag pinanood ninyo yung ating movie.
Pwede na to.
Definitely.
Oo, meron tayong this weekend. Bibinge. Definitely.
Yes.
Right. Uh-oh.
And watch it on your full screen sa bahay. Don't watch it on your laptop. Mas ma-enjoy ninyo sa widescreen. Dolby, naka-ano yun eh. 5.1 yan eh.
Wow, you guys really invested a lot on these movies, ha? Can't wait.
Parang they don't do things na half-baked or, di ba?
Oh. Hello,
My question, kasi, Robert, how do you make money from these movies?
Ano kasi, we believe if it's worth doing, it's worth doing well. Eh. I do not want to do a half-hearted job. Even for Blade Radio, talagang nag-invest tayo ng additional equipment to make it really look different from everybody else. Mm. Kasi kung gagawin mo na rin lang, ayusin mo na, di ba? And to answer your question, Eric, we do not make money on all of these things. All of these are our way of saying thank you to all our customers. We look at this as a form of advertising, not as a form of revenue making. No? Kasi you invest a lot of money in making movies.
Yeah.
No? Pero you will invest a lot more if you want to place your product into the movie. Like imagine you want to have a famous movie star to work as a Blade employee in that movie. That one will cost you multi millions. No, ang ginawa lang natin, baliktad yung approach. We created a movie with the main theme of the store. Doon na nag-revolve yung story. Doon na nag-evolve yung story. Okay. I mean, kaya na justify natin na may characters tayo na naka-Blade uniform within the movie. Magugulat ka, alam mo, kung basahin mo yung mga comments sa ating movie. Kasi yung Dito Lang Ako is like a 70s movie eh. And some people would comment on the comment box. They would say, meron bang totoong ganyang store? Meron bang totoong some people are so engrossed in the movie, they thought na ano lang, fictional lang itong tindahan na to. Some people naman would say, I did not know that there is such a store. Pupunta sila dun sa Timog Avenue para makita nila where the scenes were shot. Mga ganun. Kasi parang naging ano na eh, parang naging nakilala na yung ating store.
Oh, Ang galing nyo.
I can't wait to see it. Well, we look forward to speaking with you more when your future projects come, you know, when they come around. So, please be back when you have something new to tell us, all right? Maraming salamat, Robert Tan from Blade Auto Center.
Thank you, Eric. Thank you, Nana. Maraming
Our
salamat.
Pleasure to have you here. We'll take a quick break. GearBox will be back right after these messages.
Turn up the headlights. Turn up the headlights. Tumutok na sa GearBox. Dito sa Radyo Pilipinas. 738 AM.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino. Ano ang mga benepisyo ng pagpaparehistro sa Philippine Identification System o PhilSys? Kabilang sa mga benepisyo mula sa PhilSys ay ang mas maginhawa at mabilis na pakikipagtransaksyon sa mga ahensya ng gobyerno at sa pribadong sektor. Panukala rin ng Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas o BSP na ang PhilID ay maaaring tanggapin na requirement sa pagbubukas ng bank account o e-money account. Dahil dito, mapapadali ang pag-access ng ating mga kababayan sa basic banking services. Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at ng himpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Hey friend! Bilang isang IT expert, can you enlighten me on the security data in the Philippine Identification System o PhilSys?
Let me check the facts. Ang PhilSys ay sang-ayon sa Privacy by Design System na nagbibigay ng pangunahing prioridad sa privacy ng mga impormasyon. Ang Philippine Statistics Authority ay nakikipagtulungan rin sa mga experts mula sa National Privacy Commission at Department of Information and Communications Technology. Kaya I'm pretty confident that the personal information in PhilSys is secure.
Ikaw na friend! I owe you one!
Okay! Magpa-register na tayo!
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at ng himpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Mayroong tatlong hakbang sa pagpaparehistro sa Philippine Identification System o PhilSys. Ito ang mga sumusunod. Step 1, ang pagkolekta ng demographic information at pagtakda ng appointment para sa Step 2 ng registration process. Step 2, ang pag-validate ng demographic information at pagkolekta ng biometrics tulad ng fingerprint, iris scan at front-facing photograph. At Step 3, ang pag-issue ng PhilSys number o PSN at ng physical ID o PhilID. Magantabay sa advisory na manggagaling sa PSA sa anumang pagbabago.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at manghimpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Safe ba ang personal information sa Philippine Identification System o PhilSys? Safe ang inyong personal information sa PhilSys. Nilikha ang PhilSys alinsunod sa privacy by design kung saan pangunahing binibigyan ng halaga ang privacy, security at integrity ng personal information na registered individual sa PhilSys. Minimal o kakaunti lang na information ang nakalagay sa PhilSys at ito ay mga impormasyon na commonly given sa mga simpleng transaksyon tulad ng date of birth at address. Ang registrant ang tanging may control ng kanyang data at ang PSA ay nagsisilbing caretaker o tagapangalaga naman ng impormasyon.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at manghimpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino. Ano ang PhilID? Ang Philippine Identification o PhilID ay ang physical card na bahagi ng PhilSys. Makikita sa PhilID ang demographic information tulad ng buong pangalan, kasarian, date at place of birth, blood type at QR code kung saan nakapaloob ang PhilSys card number o PCN, piling demographic information at dalawang fingerprints. Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at manghimpilang ito.
Huwag maging backseat driver and be up to date. Be up to date. Latest car news, motoring stories at industry analysis. Gearbox. Ang roadmap mo sa mga pinakabago sa mundo ng automotive. Start the engine. Buckle up and steer the wheel. Car enthusiast man o baguhan, siguradong madaming matututunan. Gearbox. Gearbox na. Hosted by Eric.
Thank you.
Magandang gabi sa inyo lahat. Welcome back to GearBox dito sa Radyo Pilipinas. Eric with Nana at 6:13 ang ngayong Huwebes. Kasama na po natin Migs Torres from the Migs Torres Experience on YouTube. Magandang gabi, Migs. Thank you for being here.
Magandang gabi, Nana and Eric. Right from my...
Yan, ang ganda ng view.
Yan, houses here in Paranaque. Naghahanda na naman tayong magluto ng hapunan. Okay? And this time, pag-usapan natin. Yes, Nana.
Pag nakikita ko si Migs, di ba? Ang una kong tanong palagi, anong ulam?
Yes, exactly. Dahil yun eh, pag-usapan natin kung anong magandang iluto, ano? It's a dish for all occasions. And alam mo tayo mga Pilipino, napakahilig natin sa pasta. Kahit anong oras, kahit anong okasyon, basta may pasta. Basta handaan, may pasta yan.
Lalo ng mga kids, mga bata.
Oo. Oh, yung mga hilig natin yung red sauce, yung spaghetti na may red sauce, hot dog. Yung one of the episodes that we had before was Filipino spaghetti. And hindi pa rin nawawala ang affinity natin for Filipino spaghetti. Pero another growing number of Filipinos have also loved pasta carbonara. Kasi creamy, tapos iba siya sa nakasanayan natin. Yun, usually may ham yun and imbis na hot dog, no? And pag sinabi mong carbonara, naiisip niya lagyan ng cream eh. All-purpose cream, harina, cornstarch, pepper, salt, and cheese. Pero ang carbonara, ang authentic carbonara, walang cream yan. Okay? It's basically, well, pag-usapan natin ang origins ng carbonara, which actually came from Roma in Italy, mid-20th century na invent ito. And this was made for coal miners. Okay, kaya yung pangalan is carbon, carbonara, from the word carbon, from coals.
Okay.
And a lot of the earthy taste of carbonara comes from pepper. It's a peppery dish, and although hindi siya kasing peppery ng cacio e pepe, pero it still has that peppery flavor. So, para mag-inagawa ang authentic carbonara, simple ingredients lang. You need pasta, spaghetti, around 300 grams, which serves 2. And pasta water, which is salted. Importante itong mga to, okay? Eggs. Whole eggs, pero usually, modern chefs, ginagamit nila yung yolk. Kaso lang, sayang yun man yung ano. Unless gagawin mo leche flan yung, ano, yung egg whites o merengue. Or meringue.
Ano kayang difference kapag whole eggs?
But whole eggs, it's there's a lot more body to the dish. Pag yolk lang, very creamy ang kalalabasan ng dish mo. So yun yung difference niya. Use one egg every 100 grams of pasta. Now, pecorino romano, keso ito. Pwedeng, if wala kayong pecorino romano, then medyo may hapanapin yan. Parmigiano reggiano. Hindi yung parmesan cheese. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, pecorino romano is cheese. Pwedeng parmigiano reggiano, pero hindi yun yung flavor na hinahanap mo eh. Kasi ang pecorino romano, paano ko ba i-explain? Okay. Ito, medyo weird. No? Kasi nung bata ka, yung baterya, gano'n ang dila mo. Tapos medyo sobrang talas, basta matalas. Very sharp.
Hindi ko yata ginawa yun.
Ano ginawa mo sa baterya mo?
I mean,
hindi ko
ginagawa. Gano'n ang ginawa ng bata ako.
Na ginagawa yun.
Anong ginawa mo sa baterya mo?
Ginilaan ko. 9 points.
Wag mo kami isama sa mga kalokohan ng Mixer. Hindi ko rin ginawa yun ng bata ako. Ikaw lang ang... Hindi ko... Bakit ko ginilaan ng baterya?
Pero te, basta, ang lasa na ito, medyo matalas, okay? Ang parmigiano reggiano, hindi ganun katalas yung lasa niya. Pero if wala kang mahanap na pecorino romano, parmigiano reggiano na lang. Parmigiano
reggiano.
Bateriya na lang. Do not do it at home, Gearbox listeners. Okay, so, around 2 tablespoons of pecorino romano. Pwede mo rin paghaluin yan, pecorino and parmigiano. Around 2 tablespoons. Ano
yung mga gantong
keso? Sa Santis, meron yan, definitely.
Okay.
Mga deli shops, sa Stans, meron din yan, pecorino romano. Now, 2 tablespoons per 100 grams. Ito rin isa sa mga pinaka-importante. Usually ham, di ba? Yung karne ginagamit, or bacon. Ang tatamang gagamitin yung meat is guanciale. Now, guanciale is pig cheeks or pork jowl. Now, it's smoked.
So, hindi kailangan ba sa deli din bilhin yan?
Or meron, oh, sa deli mo rin bibilhin to, yung pork jowl.
Nasa palengke yan?
Hindi mo bibili sa palengke. Unless mag-cure ka ng sarili mo, ibang usapan yon. Ibang kwentuhan yon. Maggagawa ka ng sarili mo guanciale.
Cured meat na to.
Yes, this is cured meat. This will replace the bacon, the ham na nilalagay sa ano, or hindi man nire-replace, pero ito originally, no? Now there's 150 grams of guanciale, 200 grams to 200 grams. Now, pansin niyo, walang garlic, walang onion, cream, bacon, ham, mushroom, green beans, wala. Yun lang, simple. Pero medyo tricky yung ingredients and medyo mahal ito. No? Medyo pricey.
So, siya naman ng mga miners?
Well, sa Italy, madali lang kumuha ng guanciale. Madali lang kumuha ng guanciale sa Italia. Dito, medyo hindi siya ganun kasikat. Sisig, hindi mo makukuha doon. Dito, makukuha mo lagi. Now, paano mo gagawin ito? Start cooking your pasta. Pag sinabing 10 minutes, 9 minutes pa lang hanguin mo na.
Dahil yung last minute.
Oo, sundin yung buo. Pag sinunod mo yung buo, pag niluto mo yan, magiging lata na yung ano pasta, hindi siya al dente. So take it out around 8.5 to 9 minutes, if 10 minutes yung ano yung pasta cooking time. No? Palagi niyo babasahin yung label. Now, don't forget to
palagi babasahin at magsusundin.
Oh, wag niyo minus 1. Minus 1.
Migs, ibang trip mo today.
Oo nga, didilaan mo yung baterya, basahin mo yung instructions, subukin.
Hindi ko sinus. Defiant, rebel tayo today.
Iba na talaga mag-aasawa.
Well, hindi na ganyan yung freedoms mo tulad ng dati. So, yan mo yun na lang. joke lang yun. Now, baka nakikinig asawa ko, yari ako. Half tablespoon of salt, okay? Huwag masyadong madami. This will flavor your pasta. Yung ano, yung water. Save half cup of pasta water. Pagkatapos, drain, set aside. Now, gagawin natin yung sauce. Beat the eggs, okay? Then, add the cheese habang binibeat nyo yung eggs. You want the consistency na medyo paste na yung dating niya. Okay? Saute the guanciale sa pan straight until lumabas yung oils. Huwag nyo nang dadagdagan ng langis kasi pag lumabas yung langis niyan, sakto na yun. Low heat. Okay, remember, low heat kasi masusulog yung guanciale pag masyadong ano, mainit. Add the pasta water. Oh, sorry. Add the pasta pala. Add the pasta first and then coat the pasta with the oil and guanciale. Tapos lagyan nyo yung pasta water. Reduce the water hanggang nasa ilalim na lang siya. Pag nandun na, turn off the heat. Ito isa pang importanteng step. Turn off the heat kasi pag hindi nyo pinatay ito at nilagyan nyo yung egg and cheese paste mix natin, magiging scrambled eggs. Okay? Yes. Magiging so, bacon, paslog.
Wala nung pan, wala nung fire.
Yes. So, yung heat na lang ang magdadala at magiging cream. Now, what you do is you toss and you mix until makuha mo yung creamy consistency. Yun yun. Dun magiging parang cream siya yung lasa. Huwag kalimutan yung paminta. About half a teaspoon of pepper siguro. And garnish with more pecorino. And there you have it. You have your carbonara, your authentic carbonara as done by the Romans.
Sinasabi ko nga kay Migs kanina, nung nag-uusap kami before we started on the show, hindi pa pala ako technically nakakatikim ng authentic carbonara in my entire life. Kasi palaging may cream yung nakakain ko. So puro fake.
Well, it's just a different variation, I guess. It's not really fake, pero different variation lang. Kasi if you want yung authentic, yung how the Romans actually do it, you use eggs, you use pasta water. The pasta water, by the way, kaya mo ginagamit yan. Yung starch na naiipon doon pag niluluto mo yung pasta, yun na nagbabind ng egg and cheese doon sa dish mo. So that's what helps it make it creamier. Yan. Wow. So go ahead and try it. Ginawa ko yan nung Valentine's Day.
Yahoo!
Medyo na... Nah. Yes, naparami lang yung ano ko, pecorino ko. So, maalat siya. Sharp. Isang baterya. Hindi.
Parang dalawang baterya.
Oo. So, yung dadamihan yung keso, yung saktong-sakto lang. 2 tablespoons per 100 grams of pasta. Yan, natutunan ko doon. Pero yun,
all,
if you want
all this information, nasa YouTube channel mo, Migs?
Hindi ko pa ginagawa yung video. Actually, okay. I am trying to find a way.
So, nasa YouTube channel ng Gearbox.
Nasa YouTube channel ng Gearbox. Or, there's a YouTube channel that actually helps me with my pasta recipes. No? Yung Vincenzo's plate. Yun. Very helpful yun. Okay. They also teach you how to make good carbonara.
Okay. So, yan. Perfecto pag week mag-weekend na oh yung mga gusto yes. Gumawa ng carbonara fine gumawa na kayo ng totoong carbonara authentic talaga na carbonara now
oo nga
with that little battery taste
yun yung magdadala talaga eh.
So si Migs yung mga description ng keso eh no talaga namang
hindi ko alam
nawala yung audio mo Migs we can see wala na, wala yung audio mo.
Ayan. Try again.
Wala. But sa, buti na lang natapos natin yung carbonara.
Naubos na yung baterya.
Baka naubos yung baterya.
Dilaan mo ulit nga.
Para magka-power. Okay. Itatawa ko muna itong kalokohan ni Migs. But in the meantime, maraming salamat for the authentic carbonara recipe. Palagi po kayong manood ng Migs Torres Experience on YouTube. New videos every Thursday morning para matuto kayo to cook for your loved one. Really great Filipino dishes, sometimes foreign dishes as well. Thank you again, Migs Torres of the Migs Torres Experience. We'll take a quick break. Babalik ang Gearbox pagkatapos ng ilang sandali. Thanks, Migs.
Wala. Slimyador, forward, and speed up with Gearbox. Sa Radyo Pilipinas, 738 AM.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino. Maaari bang ma-access ng ibang government agencies ang personal information ng registered person sa PhilSys nang walang pahintulot? Hindi. Ang PhilSys ay sumusunod sa mga polisiya at alituntunin sa pagproseso ng mga personal na impormasyon tulad ng Data Privacy Act of the Philippines at ang mismong batas ng PhilSys o ang RA 11055. Dito nakapaloob na ang pagbibigay ng impormasyong walang pahintulot mula sa may-ari ng data o hindi naaayon sa mga batas ay maaaring patawan ng multa o pagkakakulong. Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino. Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at manghimpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin ang ID ng Pilipino.
Teacher, ano po itong bagong ID system na tinatawag na PhilSys na nakita ko sa Facebook?
Yes, ito ang tinatawag na Philippine Identification System or PhilSys na magsisilbing Central Identification Platform at magbibigay ng valid proof of identity sa lahat ng mga Pilipino.
Paano po ito naiiba sa mga ID na meron tayo ngayon?
Good question. Ang PhilSys ay magiging foundational ID system natin. Ang ibig sabihin nito, kapag kailangan mag-apply o makipag-transaksyon kung saan kailangan ng valid ID, ang PhilSys ay maaaring mong gamitin para dito. Ito rin ay isang digital ID system, kaya pwede itong gamitin kahit walang physical card dahil ang layunin talaga ng PhilSys ay mapabilis ang mga transaksyon sa government agencies at private companies.
Amazing! Ano naman po ang kailangang impormasyon para sa PhilSys?
Simple lang, ang inyong demographic information tulad ng name, gender, address, date at place of birth, blood type, at biometric information tulad ng photo, fingerprints, at iris scan.
Got it, sir! Thanks!
Hashtag ID natin, ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO, at ng himpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin, ang ID ng Pilipino.
Hey friend! Bilang isang IT expert, can you enlighten me on the security data in the Philippine Identification System of PhilSys?
Let me check the facts. Ang PhilSys ay sang-ayon sa Privacy by Design System na nagbibigay ng pangunahing prioridad sa privacy ng mga impormasyon. Ang Philippine Statistics Authority ay nakikipagtulungan rin sa mga experts mula sa National Privacy Commission at Department of Information and Communications Technology. Kaya I'm pretty confident that the personal information in PhilSys is secure.
Ikaw na friend! I owe you one!
Okay! Magpa-register na tayo!
Hashtag ID natin, ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at ng himpilang ito.
Hashtag ID natin, ang ID ng Pilipino.
Ano ang mga benepisyo ng pagpaparehistro sa Philippine Identification System o PhilSys? Kabilang sa mga benepisyo mula sa PhilSys ay ang mas maginhawa at mabilis na pakikipagtransaksyon sa mga ahensya ng gobyerno at sa pribadong sektor. Panukala rin ng Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas o BSP na ang PhilID ay maaaring tanggapin na requirement sa pagbubukas ng bank account o e-money account. Dahil dito, mapapadali ang pag-access ng ating mga kababayan sa basic banking services.
Hashtag ID natin, ang ID ng Pilipino.
Isang paalala mula sa PSA, PCOO at ng himpilang ito.
Itodo na ang Slinyador, Forward and Speed Up with GearBox sa Radyo Pilipinas, 738 AM.
GearBox dito sa Radyo Pilipinas, we're live on the AM band. Just go to the frequency 738 AM. We're also live online.
Yes, we are on Facebook. Catch us at GearBox RP1.
At ngayon naman, we introduce our second guest of the show, the co-founders of Mercato Centrale, RJ and Vanessa Ledesma, on the show this evening. Magandang gabi sa inyo lahat.
Hi guys, good evening. Thanks so much for having us on the show. Much appreciated. Hello, how
are
you?
Our pleasure.
Hello, long time no see, RJ and Vanessa.
Long time no see in the flesh, but virtually. It's good to see both of you. Gusto ko na sabihin sa aking kasama ngayong gabi, ang ganda mo. Ang ganda mo, Vanessa.
Oh.
Papo ko, by the way, your Eric, colors complement each other, ah, maganda.
Papo pala, Eric. Papo mo rin, Eric. At,
thank you. But I like the colors, ah, the blue and the green. We really complement each other.
Yeah, perfect. No. Lasalista, tenista, eh. Kaya tama-tama. I'm wearing my Mercato shirt, so that's why it's Mercato there.
Okay. So let's talk about Mercato. What's going on at Mercato now? How is everything with the pandemic?
Ako, ito, yung boss ko.
Okay, so during the pandemic, of course, we had to close, no? Kasi we fall under mass social gathering. So when that happened, wow, my heart sank. Pero I also realized that, you know, we're at that time, di ba, sinasabi ng lahat, we are at war. And at war, we are in a crisis. So I realized as an entrepreneur, during a crisis, magsa-stop ba ko, sleep, watch Netflix, and just let pass and think that everything's gonna go back to normal when they lift the pandemic end of March? No. I knew deep inside, this is gonna go on. This is a virus, just like the Spanish flu. So Mercato Central, we never slept. So within 2 to 3 weeks, we pivoted kaagad-agad nana to an online platform. So we moved all of our merchants from the night bustling night live market to an online marketplace. But bukod pa doon, we learned so many, you know, we learned the hard way. We learned everything was just on the spot. We had our own riders. Talagang we did everything mano-mano. But because of all the road closures, so many difficulties, we realized, you know, we have to pivot some more and more and more. So we launched Mobile Mercatos. We brought the market into the condo dwellers. What else did we launch? And finally, my favorite, well, RJ has two other favorite projects that he's cooking up. But my ultimate favorite when it comes to the live markets is we launched what you call Mercato Prime. I medyo out of breath. Sige, RJ, ikaw naman mag-explain. Ano yung Mercato Prime?
Napagod na.
I'm listening to us.
Anyway. Wait. Teka muna. Sandali. Na-overwhelm ako ang dami. So you said you brought Mercato online. Where is this? How do they access Mercato online?
They go to
www.mercatofavorites.com. But then, yung talaga gusto kong ipunto lang dito, the point that we want to make over here is that during the crisis, as entrepreneurs, it's a series of iterations. The mindset kasi, if you're an entrepreneur, is that failure is an investment in learning. And during this crisis, there was a lot of failures, but as an investment in learning on how to redo your business during the new normal. Among them was to create what we call a Mercato Cloud Kitchen, where we aggregated the vendors from their own homes, and then we would deliver. So basically, if you look at the website, Mercato Cloud Kitchen, you're ordering from one vendor or multiple vendors, but they actually live in different areas. And we found out that, you know, the cost was very high for people. I mean, if you get it, you get a delivery charge per vendor, right? So it's different.
Yeah.
That was a learning. So that didn't work out as well as we wanted to. So that was a learning. And the other learning that we had was that during this crisis was that both restaurants and also small food vendors were the ones suffering. It was a great equalizer, so they were both suffering. So what did we do? Around September, October, when there was a need to balance off health and economy, we were able to go back to the city of Taguig and work with the Taguig City Safe City Task Force. And what we developed was a safe, socially distanced outdoor market which conformed to IATF protocols, which is what Vanessa was referring to earlier on as the Mercato Prime. It was very good. It was a way for us to jumpstart and have businesses bounce back, really. And to, you know, as you know, it's actually safer to be outdoors than right now it is to be indoors. So, in other words, our expertise worked very well, was leveraged very, very well for these outdoor markets.
But more than that, what was nice is for 10 years, we've been helping SMEs and MSMEs, small food entrepreneurs. But during the pandemic, we felt the need to spread our wings and to help not only the SMEs, but also the restaurant industries. Even fine dining restaurant became our merchants in our live Mercato Prime markets that started off in Bonifacio High Street. So restaurants such as Wolfgang Steakhouse, Galerie by Chele, La Picara, they joined
El
us.
Chupacabra.
El Chupacabra. So what was nice is that they also learned how to pivot, not just to serve fine dining indoor restaurant style, but also selling products that are bagay for an alfresco market. And the price points are also very presyong pandemic. So for example, Wolfgang Steakhouse, their most affordable steaks are maybe 5,000-7,000 per set, no? But in Mercato, BGC, they pivoted to selling USDA prime burgers for only 450 pesos or something like that. So same quality, but just different, and they're able to sell. They're able to move their products as well. So it also helped restaurants and the food industry like them.
Yes. And the bigger message that we want to communicate here, Nana and Eric, if there are any food entrepreneurs over there, is that we're opening more markets right now. We realize that's one of the key strengths of Mercato. We've opened up two markets right now in BGC. We have one SM by the bay overlooking, of course, Manila Bay. We'll have one in Sky Ranch as well.
Opening tomorrow.
And we're going to be opening in several other places in Megaworld, in Ayala, in SM. And as a result, you know, we're looking for more unique and innovative food dishes or food concepts from entrepreneurs. So if they want to join the market, please feel free to do so.
Or even if you're an established restaurant, yeah, if you want to learn how to pivot and how to sell in an online, in an alfresco setting, this is the chance to give it a try.
All you have to do is just go to our Mercato Central Facebook page. Tell them you heard us here on the Gearbox by Nana and Eric. And
it seems you guys are extremely busy. I mean, one thing after another, you know. But so the online is still happening. It's still available. So
it's a more of a pivot to really online because the thing. So Eric and Nana, just, you know, as a disclaimer, I teach entrepreneurship. I'm an entrepreneur. So we were teaching people like during this time that you've got to rethink your business models and understand what your brand essence is. The reason I'm saying this one is because we realize that the real essence of Mercato, brand essence, is that we are a small food business incubator. We're not a food market. We're a small food business incubator. You can incubate offline, which is your brick and mortar structure and outdoor, and you can incubate online, which is what we did with the business that we created. We created online businesses. But our brand essence right now is to incubate both new food vendors from an online and an offline perspective. Very soon, you'll be seeing a Mercato app where we will be helping vendors, like aspiring food MSMEs from their homes. You know, right now, the bigger delivery aggregators like GrabFood and Foodpanda, basically they cater to restaurants. But the underserved market and the one that's been growing very fast during this pandemic are the food MSMEs, the home-based and online food centers.
Oh.
We're going to have a Mercato app where we will aggregate all of them online so you can find them.
So this is an app you can download sa iPhone and then Android, and then these brands, MSME brands, will be there and you can order from them?
Exactly, yeah. We're working that together with Multisys. Multisys is the same developer as the Stay Safe app. If you've seen the Stay Safe app.
Yeah, of course. Uh-uh.
Yeah, we're both very aligned because we're both advocates. And so David Almirol of Multisys is an advocate for these type of things. So we got together and we said, how can we... You know, we're all about, as entrepreneurs, we're all about solving pain points. That's one big pain point which we have. How do we help more entrepreneurs? And the second thing that's coming up is our Mercato United Kitchen. Vanessa will tell you more about that.
So the Live Cloud Kitchen, as RJ mentioned earlier, one of the learnings that we had when we launched the online platform is kasi may tinatawag sa amin, we did our market research before, pre-COVID. When you say tara Mercato tayo, usually a group of 6 to 8 goes together to Mercato. And what happens is, customer behavior yan, each six of them go to different stalls. So 6 different stalls. Tapos, they come together in one table and then they share the food.
Right,
so that's
right.
The Mercato experience na our customers love. Nawala yun eh. Nawala yun during the pandemic. Kasi nga, you cannot go to one online marketplace, order from different vendors, and get it at the same price. There's a delivery fee. Yun yung pain point. So to solve that pain point, we had to put up a cloud kitchen, which we call... it's also different from a cloud kitchen because the cloud kitchen, they share the kitchen. They do all the same. We cannot do it that way because we have very specialized, individualized merchants that have special spices, special different ingredients each. So what we're going to do is a united kitchen where each merchant has an individual kitchen specialized for themselves. And then, but it works like a cloud kitchen. It's just in one venue. So the delivery fee will be just
one delivery fee.
So the customer will now have that on experience of being tara Mercato tayo, being able to purchase from different vendors.
Mercato
favorite top vendors, and just with one delivery fee online. And the extra topping for this. Today's a extra topping for this United kitchen is the fact that it's not just Mercato favorites. We're also, just like the Mercato Prime, we're also opening our doors, not just to any restaurant, but specially chosen restaurants that are difficult to order from. But I cannot yet, no?
Yeah.
But we cannot yet divulge.
But we're also
exciting restaurants.
If people also want to apply for the market, we're more than happy to support the small aspiring food vendors or restaurants. You know, some of them have to cut down on costs so they can join our United Kitchen at the same time. And online, we're also available. We now have Grab Food and Lazada, so you can order Mercato outdoor from our outdoor markets. You can now order via Grab Food and also via Lazada. And very soon, you'll be able to order through the Ayala Zing app at the same time. And you'll find us very soon on other apps as well. So that's what we do. Oh, also, Food PH. That's the app on the Viber, in the Viber community.
I don't know how you guys find the time to do all this. I mean, just listening to how you're putting all of this together is, wow, I'm like blown away. Galing.
It's more
RJ, you mentioned that you are an entrepreneur. And then Vanessa, you also mentioned that you're helping, that you're inviting restaurants to pivot and learn to sell in the alfresco setting. So my question is, do you help them, guide them when they join you? Whether it's a restaurant or a small home business?
Of course. One of the things that we have, one of the programs we have, is what you call Mercato Academy, where we teach them step-by-step process on the five different departments on running a business. Operations, finance, marketing, HR, and biz dev. So we teach them most especially finance and marketing, because that's where, you know, they have to figure out their food costs, things like that. But when it comes to the restaurants, going back to your question, we're so delighted to really help them. And I have to say, the ones who really listen, because, I mean, we don't force them to follow our advice, no? But the ones who really listen are those who are doing very well in the market. They sell so well, and they stay on in the market because, you know, it's an extra sale for them. It's a satellite restaurant, satellite table for them to have additional sales.
Okay, so you have the website. What is the website? The one that where you can order from? You mentioned na
it's called Mercato Favorites, but we strongly recommend that the best place to order right now from is Grab Food.
So Grab.
And very soon you will see our 2.0 Mercato Favorites website, and you'll see that it will have all of our United Kitchen items. And on top of that, well, very soon you'll have the Mercato app, and you know everything will be together in that app.
So right now they look for Mercato Kitchen sa Grab, tama?
Just look for Mercato on Grab.
Mercato. Okay.
Mercato Central Grab.
That's what we have for now until the United Kitchen is
comes
launched.
Out. Yeah. Okay. When?
Yes.
That'll be by June, around June.
The United Kitchen is the one where you can order, which is from different vendors, which is from delivery price. Yes.
Galing. And go ahead, Nana.
Okay, go ikaw.
No, go ahead.
Okay, jahan po. No, so you're inviting now businesses and restaurants. Are there criteria, like how do you evaluate which one you can accommodate?
Okay, well, actually, at the start, everybody's invited to try out. But we have a very stringent process on selecting which merchants are ready to join the market. We have what you call a very stringent taste test. We have a board of taste testers. Unfortunately, I'm part of. That's why we
can we apply?
Yeah, exactly. I was just saying. Really, unfortunately, I mean, I'm sure people are lining up around that.
It's a tough job, but somebody's got to do it.
Exactly.
But we really take it seriously. We really have great cards, and not to discourage these aspiring entrepreneurs, we always give them advice as to how to better their dishes, to make it more sellable with the target market, especially which market they plan to join. No? So we're very, I believe we're very encouraging naman. We're not naman, hindi masarap, goodbye. No, we give them a chance on how they can better their dishes, their presentation most especially. So there, those things, and of course, right now, during this COVID pandemic, we have what you call a very, very friendly terms and rental fees with our merchants. I have to say, we go as low as a percentage of sale. And that will surely help them out. And so that's why our, you know, Mercato really, truly is an advocacy at the end of the day. You know, we're here helping out not just the SMEs, but the food industry to bounce back. So more than ever now, especially during the pandemic, really want to help. That's why we keep these rental fees very low, if not a percentage of sales lang. If you sell, that's the only time you pay. And we're very happy because our lessor partners, especially Ayala, BGC, SM, they've been also very helpful with our advocacy and our mission vision. So we're very thankful that everyone's so aligned with our DMO during this crisis. So it's been good. Been very good. Yeah. With God's grace, been very okay.
That's good to hear. Now, you mentioned yung Mercato Prime. Ano? You have two locations already that are open?
Actually, we have three. And three, the fourth one will be open tomorrow in Tagaytay. So, we have we used to have just one location in Bonifacio High Street. But happily, they gave us two separate locations down the strip from the north and one in the south.
So, two locations at BGC.
Two locations in BHS, and then a third one in SM by the Bay.
Okay.
Where the fountain is, Max Center, where the fountain is and where the fireworks are. And then the fourth location will be in SM Sky Ranch.
Tagaytay.
Which is opening tomorrow.
Tomorrow. And then we have a fifth one opening right after Holy Week in Nuvali. Nuvali.
Wow.
And then right after that, to be announced.
Since you're opening Sky Ranch tomorrow, can you tell us more about it? Like, how many merchants are there?
Sure. For tomorrow?
Yeah, for tomorrow, for Sky Ranch.
So the SM Sky Ranch, it's a bit tricky because we've actually wanted to open it since last month pa. But, you know, there's these alerts about the volcano.
Yeah.
You know? So, it's been setting us back. But whenever we ocular naman in Tagaytay, the locals there are saying it's false alarm. It's not naman true. They're exaggerating. So, we've been very, you know, about it. But happily, we have 20 merchants lined up that's very excited to launch in that market, and we have about 20 more lined up. May wait list, wow. Wait list now, but they also still want to see how, that's how it is, that they want to see how the market opens, how it runs. But the foot traffic there is incredible, especially during weekends.
Especially now, despite the pandemic, marami nang tao.
Distance. I mean, that's our
siguro, that's
That's our number one. We really made sure during this pandemic, because we know our Mercato had always been known to have a massive foot traffic. Pre-COVID, our foot traffic would reach an average of 5,000 to 8,000 per night.
Wow.
Yes. Yeah, so I can understand why we had to close down. But because of that reputation that Mercato has, we felt the need that the number one thing that we have to follow and we have to be known for during this pandemic is we are a socially distanced, safe alfresco market that is safe even for kids to go. But, you know, so we pride in that. So there, but the foot traffic in Tagaytay per se is not dropping. Everybody just wants to go out. You know, they really are looking for spaces and for places that is safe and worth leaving the house for. Yes, worth. And when I say worth, all the senses are touched. From the sight, the scent of the food, the taste, of course. And even, you know, sometimes we even have designers fix our place now to make it Instagrammable.
That's very important these days.
Right. They don't want to just leave the house just to eat. There has to be, you know, is it a place, safe place to meet people? Is it something that we can take pictures with? Is the food affordable? Is it suited to go out the house? Mm. Is it yummy? You know, all these senses have to now be touched, which, well, that's what we believe. Hence, we really try our best to touch all those senses. And lastly, is it safe? So all five senses. Mm. Did I forget?
I'm so done.
All these prime locations, Vanessa, well, they're open from what time until what time? And is it daily, Monday to Sunday?
Iba-iba siya. So, High Street is only open Friday to Sunday, but longer hours, starting from 11 a.m. all the way to 9:30 p.m. So, you have lunch and dinner. Mm-hmm. SM by the Bay is open every day except for Tuesdays. But it's only open from 3 p.m. up to 10 p.m.
Okay.
Okay. Sky Ranch in Tagaytay will be open every Thursday to Sunday. Same lunch, 11 a.m. down to 9:30 p.m. Iba-iba, we figure out the times when people are hungry. We do a lot of observation and studies before we figure out the operating times of each market. So we don't have a standard, you know. That's it.
Yeah.
It's open this time.
Okay, so if they want to know more about the schedule, the locations, the merchants, where do they go? Website, social media accounts?
The best is through our webs, our social media accounts, because we have 24/7 people looking at that. Message us on Facebook, even Instagram. And then the persons there will get back to you. And if they don't, please complain by Ledesma or Vanessa Ledesma. Drop in, hey, your person. It's been 2 hours. Yeah, complain to us. We're also in
So what's the handle again? So Facebook, it's Mercato? Mercato Centrale.
But more importantly, more importantly for the vendors who want to join, potential food merchants, if you want to try. If you're an aspiring food entrepreneur, you think your food has got potential, we invite you to join us. We've had the chance to incubate, grow, and scale many food businesses. They started from us. They learned the ropes. They were able to expand and grow. And we look forward to finding the next big food entrepreneur who's listening right now to GearBox.
Yeah. One quick advice for somebody who is aspiring to be a food entrepreneur.
During the pandemic, I have to say, this is the time to get it on. This is the time to start it. This is the time to go out there and launch your product. You know, because the way I see things during a pandemic, parang siyang war, right? I mentioned earlier, everyone's starting from zero. I mean, most often than not, everyone had a setback. So imagine you have that sort of equal advantage as everyone else. Even the biggest players had to fall, had some setback. So imagine this is the only chance you're almost in the same level of playing field as them. So the earlier you start, the bolder you get on with that, with your product, the faster you're gonna get to your finish line. I mean, it's just, for me, it's just completely logical. And one of the people that inspired me to do this is actually my Lola. During the war, and my great-grandfather during the war, that was actually when they flourished. That was when my Lolo started his steel factory. And you know, my Lola at 16, she was befriending mga Americans to sell Blue Seal cigarettes. I mean, you know, there's so many things you can do. If they could have, they did it during the time when it was even harder. What more now? We have social media, we have online things. I mean, yeah. We're pretty pampered. If you compare this war compared to how it was before, we're pretty pampered. So, for me, no excuses not to start today.
All right, do it. Do it now. Do it right away.
Do it now.
Thank you. Thank you very much for your time. Very enlightening. Look forward to trying out Mercato Prime. RJ and Vanessa Ledesma of Mercato Central, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks so much.
Thank you, Nana.
Appreciate for being here on the show. Thank you to our crew, Roger Cruz, Marvin Toledana, F. Gaitos for Nana Nadal. I'm Eric Tipan. We are out of time, but thank you for watching GearBox. We'll catch you again next week.
Thank you, GearBox.
Thanks, RJ.
You're always on the go. On the go. Pero ang mahuli sa balita is always a big no-no. Kaya, Radyo Pilipinas is here to keep you updated. Reliable news delivered to you as